In Creo Parametric, the shell feature hollows out a part, leaving you with a wall thickness that you can control. To start a shell feature, you can click on the command in the ribbon in the Model tab. And then, from the References tab, the first collector that's active is what surfaces you want to remove. I'll start by removing this surface from the picture. Right now, we don't see a preview of the geometry because the thickness is too big. To change the thickness, you can use the drag handle, and as I drag it smaller, I can see the preview of the feature. I realize that there is another surface that I want to remove, so I will hold down the Control key to select this surface as well. That looks more like what I want. Let's change the thickness here to a value of 4. Be aware that you can also thicken to the outside of the part. And very commonly, I use this when I am designing things like pressure vessels or other different containers where I want to control the volume and then add thickness to the outside. Also, you can have a non-default thickness. For example, maybe I want the bottom surface to be thicker than the rest of the part. I can hold down the right mouse button to activate the non-default thickness collector. You can also collect in this field as well. And then I can pick this bottom surface, and I've got an additional drag handle, and I can make this bottom surface thicker, like using a value of 10. From the Options tab, you're able to exclude some different surfaces. Let me show you what I mean by that. I'm going to hit the check mark to complete this feature, and let's turn on our datum plane visibility so I can create a cross section. I'll go to the View tab and then Section and Planar. I know I want to use this datum plane over here. That looks good. Let me also use the default color for the surfaces and add some crosshatching in here and hit the check mark. Let's turn off the datum plane visibility and hop back over to the Model tab. And right now you can tell from the cross section that the handle is also being shelled out. And this is going to be hard for me to manufacture. And really, I don't want the handle to be shelled. So in order to change that, let's go back to the model tree so I can find my shell feature and then use Edit Definition from the mini toolbar. Now I'll go to the Options tab and I can click in the Excluded Surfaces Collector or right mouse click and hold and choose to activate the Exclude Surfaces Collector. Let me actually cancel for a second and turn off the display of my cross section. Now let's go back to the shell feature, Edit Definition, and activate the Exclude Surfaces Collector. I'm going to pick the surfaces involved with the handle. I will use the Control key to select the surfaces. Let's rotate to view on the other side. And again, just continue on with my left mouse clicks. And I just picked those 10 surfaces manually. I could have used other advanced selection techniques, but that does the trick. Now let's hit the check mark and activate the cross section again. And now you can see that we have the part shelled. Here we have a bigger thickness on the bottom surface, and we've excluded the handle from the shelling operation. And another part to demonstrate this, let me start off by selecting a surface in the model. You can get to the shell command from the mini toolbar, and by starting off with that surface, it automatically added it to the Remove Surfaces collector. Once again, I can hold down the Control key to select an additional surface. I can click to add a surface with a non-default thickness. I can make this with a really big value. Let's double click on the dimension and turn a value of 25 over here and 2 for the main thickness. And in that way, I can create my shell feature and middle mouse button in order to complete it. I hope you enjoyed this video. For more information, please visit www.creowindchill.com. If you learned something from this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you like this video, please click the subscribe button to be informed when new videos are uploaded. Thank you very much.